I want to introduce you to a church that's doing some creative things, just quietly under the radar. I'm at St. Vincent Catholic Church, and what's exciting is, although they're not opening their parish, they have set up a pavilion over here, and there's picnic tables, the homeless stay under there. There's a porta potty set up over here, tents underneath nearby. Tell us your name.
Antonio. I need to ask a question. What are they going to do about us this winter, Larry Rice? They're going to allow y'all to open?
I don't know if we'll be able to do that, but we're going to do what we can as far as opening up safe houses, opportunities, because it's really, really hard. Now, you're here. At least this church has that pavilion over there for you. You sleep under that. It's cold. We can find you at a place. There's a toilet over here. There's even some tents back over there.
Yes, sir.
It's not ideal. It's been meeting some needs during the spring and summer, but I wished if churches all over did that, better than people being pushed from place to place,
They move us like cattle. They move us like cattle. They move us from spot to spot. And that's why a lot of us that have lived in the shelter with you last, wish it was open. Even though it didn't open until 6, we didn't have to move around.
Yeah, so we knew. Get back open. I know we do. It grieves me.
If we had an address, we could get our mail and everything. Now we don't.
Well, you know, there's tremendous pressure on Mayor Jones from this big money downtown St. Louis. They want the homeless out of sight, out of mind. They closed our place, blaming all the problems on the homeless. And then it's like the wrath of God fell on Washington Street. They have to barricade the streets now. Buildings getting shot up.
Yeah.
I mean, people getting shot. I mean, they can't blame the homeless because they closed us down, but they're trying to keep us closed down.
Yes, sir. I just hope that they can do something. Y'all still fighting in court?
Well, at this point, not now, but we probably very likely will because we're resubmitting our architectural plans. The last time we did that, the rich people sued us in the city. But the trouble is then, under the Crusoe administration, the city was against us. Now I'm told that they're at least going to give us a fair shake, which is much better.
It's over 150 of us homeless in this city. If you can't, I'm saying you got a lot of churches that help, Larry, but you was the main source. And until they do something, we're going to be stuck here.
People can freeze to death.
Yeah, last year I almost froze. Literally, I almost froze. Larry, you know they didn't start bringing a warming bus out until like the end of, right after Christmas? September, October, and November, we didn't have nothing. We was out in the cold.
Well, we're going to have to work even harder this year, not only get a place for them to go, but also see it's got the warm clothes. That's why we've declared October is Socktober.
Yes, sir. It's going to be, it's getting chilly now at night. So imagine in October, what it's going to be like.
Keep in mind, 8 o'clock, the second Saturday in October, we're going to block off the street in front of 1411 Locust, have a lot of stuff there for y'all, okay?
Thank you, Larry.
In the meantime, there's some stuff for you,
okay?
So many people right now need bus tickets. People need help right now. People are homeless. And again, I see this man indicated, they're surviving us better than what a lot of churches are doing. So how are you today, sir? Are you homeless?
Yeah.
Tell us your name.
Harold Kirby.
So you spend time under the pavilion out here stuff.
Yeah, waiting for food, stuff like that, yeah.
Right. I'd love to be able to see churches all over do something. This is, of course, you'd like maybe do more, but hey, they're doing this. This is great. This is something.
Right, yes. All the people out here are getting more and more because people are losing their jobs, people losing houses, stuff like that. So families out here, the kids out here on the streets.
And we have so many out here that need transportation assistance now. So many people out here living out here, like you said, families with kids that are out here now.
Yes, I've seen some like that, yeah.
How did you ever end up homeless?
I've been out here like four or five years, off and on.
What's going to get you off these streets for sure?
I'm working with people through a company down here, I can't think of the name, but they're helping me out.
Well, we're going to try to help you as much as we can today. Right. We see the pavilion over here. I like, if churches all over, just let the homeless be on their pavilions and stop running them off their property.
Right.
This church at least lets them be there.
Yeah.
They put a porta potty over here, places people set up tents if you need to. The need is so great.
Here's another thing, that building over there is empty. Yeah. They can convert that over to homeless people. I mean, I don't know how much money it would take. But what happens is it takes one person to make a mistake, and they don't want anybody back in.
Well, that's the trouble. You know, they look like they want to just push the homeless out. They blame them for the problems.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
They closed down our building at 1411 Locust.
Wow.
And then we were taking 150, 200 people a night in there. They blame the homeless for all these little things around going on.
Uh-huh.
Once they pushed us out of the area,
yeah.
they began to see it wasn't the homeless. They got people in cars that are shooting each other on Washington Street, shooting into the buildings. Yeah. They've got to put pyramid gates to stop them up there. Yeah. It's like the wrath of God fell on the greed of those people out there.
Mm-hmm.
Well, we got to try to help you as much as we can here today. And I just want you to know that you're not alone. The Lord loves you, brother.
Yeah. And another thing I want to say is there are people out here that have got no education. And I tried to get hold of that Lutheran school over there. It's been a long time ago before I made it in apartments. But I was trying to get hold of it and bring homeless people in there that wanted to go back to work.
Yes.
Okay, they have a gym to work out. They can run back and forth, weights in there. And also what I want to do is got a kitchen in there where people want to learn how to cook. They go to these restaurants and get jobs.
Yes.
And I plan on having a Bible study there. And the ones that didn't know how to read or write, or didn't have a diploma, I was going to have them taught, you know. Turn the place in where people can come out of there and go to work. Have labor pool, doctors, and all this there.
That'd be great.
Really but be that's good. What, you know, if you buy another building like that, you'd be surprised. But let people in and let them do what they got to do. But most of them out of shape. So therefore, they had to have a place to go. I mean, run or work out with weights and stuff like that before they get back to work.
God, that's a great idea, and I thank God for people that have indicated that they do care. Bernie Hayes recently talked to Sheriff Betts. He was explaining that. Was said he wants to help us get some turkeys together for Thanksgiving. Pray he does that. But there are so many people that continue to remain out on the streets at this time.
Sheriff Betts, another thing, too, that people perhaps may be a little confused about, the homeless situation here in the city of St. Louis. And I know you personally were protecting those downtown, protecting those who were on the street. While a lot of people, say the Metropolitan Police Department, had orders to remove some of them. But you were actually in their corners. Tell us about why you did that.
Well, of course, those are the underprivileged, the people who have come upon bad, I guess we would say, bad luck in life, you know, and they deserve a hand up or a hand out to try to help them get back up on their feet and stable. And I just kind of have a heart for doing that. I come past the homeless that hang out in the park across from my civil court building. I come by that way every day. And so I stop often. I know a lot of those homeless guys by name and ladies. And there's always an occasion for me to try to help them. A matter of fact, I have a project right now where it's a couple of them, they think that they can get kind of up on their feet if they can get their birth certificate. So just day before yesterday, I went into City Hall, see what it costs to get a copy of a birth certificate, and it's only $10. So I got plans, if not today, Monday, I'm going to get a couple of those homeless folk who I've actually made build a relationship with are going to come by the courthouse, and then I'm going to walk over to City Hall and help them get their birth certificates, and then from there get their ID and maybe help them from there get employment. So because I live so close to the downtown area, I'm constantly interacting with those folk because I work downtown. Sometime on my lunch break, I'll go over and talk with them to see if there's something that I can do or what are they getting into. And then, like I said, because I live so close, and my guys on Fridays, Saturdays, and Sundays are actually working downtown, when I come down to check on my detail, I also, a lot of times, check on the homeless to see how they're doing and what we can do to help them out.
You truly are a public servant.
I can't get on the MetroLink without no bus ticket because
God is good.
Yeah, God always good. God always good. Get on the MetroLink without a bus ticket, I can get locked up, so, yeah. That's a good thing. I can validate it and get on the MetroLink. Or I can get on the bus, but I don't want to get on the bus because the 95 don't run down here. It ain't no bus that really runs the situation. Best thing to do is get on the train, though. So.
God bless you.
Thank you, Ray. You have a good day, Ray.
How you doing, Ray?
Good morning. How are you?
I'm good, sir. How you doing?
I'm good, okay.
So how are you surviving these days?
Oh, I'm great. I just called Father Mark and Pastor Mark and Larry. Reverend Rice before they left. I deposited some information with him that I've been compiling for the last 2 years about events that happened down here. But it's very well documented. It's about 6 pages long. I gave it to Pastor Mark before they drove out, but it's eventually being directed to Chris because Chris be doing the writing on these circulars every week. So that's that.
Well, I'm glad that you can be a part of that.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Share your ideas.
Oh, yeah. This is it. It's not ideas. It's about things that actually happen with this drugs, that potpourri and all of that. But you may not remember, but some guys, they were really, really high, ran out in the middle of the street, August of 19. But I had a day, I told them to get the camera, see what happened. But always, always. And I talked to them about how they closed down the Centenary, the Horizon Club, Larry Rice, all at the same time. Right? It's intentional and it's with malice.
A lot of people don't understand that. I'm glad that you can share from your perspective.
For sure.
That's so very powerful.
For sure. Thank you. All right, sir.
Here
thank you. Thank you.
Ray, we see so many people who are just really hurting every single day. And, you know, a lot of people who are doing this kind of social work, we have to deal with a lot, right? Sometimes we need to be ministered to because we just see such a great need and we are not always able to fill that.
Well, that's certainly true. There are so many, many hurts of people that we see. But yet they, you know, many of them will have the fortitude to continue on, and we can even learn from that. And it can be an encouragement to us to see how people who sometimes have nothing are still carrying on. And many of them, it's because they believe in the Lord Jesus, and that's what makes the real difference in their lives.
Absolutely, and it's what makes a difference in our lives too, and that's kind of what separates us and apart from people who might be doing this job for other reasons, is that we feel called, we read the Scripture, we recognize that this is what God has called us to do. So he sustains us, but we need your prayers too for all of us as, you know, we see the needs of people every single day, and, you know, it can feel overwhelming sometimes.
Yes, we do need the prayers of God's people. It's always been a real vital element of New Life Evangelistic Center's prayer. I remember back in the early days, there were prayer groups that we would keep in contact with on a regular basis, sharing the needs, and they would lift us up in prayer, and we would, you know, let them know how things were coming along, and that still is a very vital part of this ministry.
Yeah, and prayer has power. Prayer changes us from the inside, changes our external situation as God answers the prayer of his saints, and so we need your prayer as we continue to fill the needs of those. How are you doing today?
Oh, all right. I'm blessed. How y'all doing?
Okay. You're blessed. You're doing well.
I really am, except for just with the housing. And I got patience with that because I know the Lord is just going to have me waiting for a little bit more longer. So I'm just going to sit by the pool and wait for the Lord.
So you've applied to housing. You're just...
Yeah, waiting. I already did. Yes. I've been applying for that 2 years ago.
You're on a waiting list right
yes,
now?
Yes, to BJC. Plus, I was sleeping in front of St. Patrick's on the ground. But because I wasn't in a tent with somebody, they told us they couldn't put us in the housing or no hotels. And the people that they put in the hotels, they paid up for them 2 to 3 days. So yesterday evening, that's when the day was up for them yesterday. All those people came back outside within 3 days, and now they sleep outside overnight again. So they back.
And it's hard, isn't it?
It's very hard. It's hard to reach the system, and it's hard to reach somebody's mind to get them to understand where you're coming from on a certain level when you have to be reached. So we can't be reached if you have no phone, and we can't be reached when you don't have an ear.
Absolutely. And people are not necessarily listening. They've got their job, they're doing their job, but it's hard for them to get to listen to you and to understand what's really going on.
Like right now, I have been in Larry Rice program before, but I had left due to the fact that I was fighting for my son from Olivine to the city. So I had to wind up leaving from out there because all my drops is in the city. No transportation back and forth. However, I was on an attic. Now that I have been clean for the last month, I'm asking to come back to the program that I know God can help me get on my feet faster that way. because what man won't do for you, God will. He has all power. He don't stop the houses, and the Lord will never stop the shelters.
And so he's walking through this season with you.
He has walked through 5 seasons with me out here. And my mission was, everybody keep asking me, T.T., why you still outside on the ground? Because of what Larry and them don't do. They don't sleep with y'all out here at night. My mission is to, he told me 2002, make sure all the young people was gone before I left. That's why I'm still here. And yes, I am tired. My body tired too, and my mouth. But I feel like I gotta help myself first. And it's starting to feel like that because of the people that I've been helping. It ain't working. And so I say to you all, y'all keep doing what you're doing. Keep blessing these people because God got a door for y'all and he got a crown for you. And if you want the crown, you got to do right by him. And all everybody ain't favored by the Lord, you understand? But he has his chosen ones. And those ones will be in a place soon with hot water, running water, and a bed to sleep in.
Absolutely. Well, we've got some bus passes for you. Thank you very much.
So appreciate you. God bless you.
God bless you.
And nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
Good morning. How are you doing?
Man, I'm all right, man. I'm happy to be here, for real.
You happy to be here?
Yeah, man. Because y'all here be out a lot.
So does that mean a lot to...
To get around, man.
Yeah, so the tickets?
Man.
Oh, yeah. You and me both, we got to tie our shoes here. I'll wait a moment. Oh, you're going to tie my shoe? Well, thank you. That's like Jesus washing his disciples' feet. Thank you very much. Well, God bless you. That's a real servant's heart there. Oh, you all right?
Yeah, man, I got a chest pain.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Do you have that a lot?
I'm from Kansas Bus to the hospital now.
Okay, well, we do want to help you. We're thankful that we have these, can help people in this way. It's a very vital thing, these bus tickets. We can't take it for granted. We purchase these tickets from the Metro.
Do y'all still go out of town and do work?
We do have a training program, yes.
Yeah.
It starts out in New Bloomfield for the men.
Where's that?
For the men, they start in New Bloomfield. Okay. We have a farm out there.
Yeah.
That's the beginning of the training program. And
mm-hmm.
Yeah, if you'd be interested in that, we could talk with you about that, too.
Okay.
Well, God bless you. Here.
Okay.
Yeah. I think Chris has them.
Chris?
So, y'all interview on that port today? Yeah, interview on that port?
I'd have to probably set an appointment to meet with you.
Okay, well.
Okay, and then
we can do it.
He wants to do an interview too.
Hi. How you doing?
Hi, good. How are you?
All right.
So what's happening in your life?
Nothing, really.
Are you homeless now? Or?
Yeah, I'm sleeping on the street. Trying to get a place over at the Mark Twain and signed up at Patriot Temporary Work Services. So I'm trying to get some work over there.
How long have you been on the streets?
I don't even know. 5 months, maybe. I was in a homeless shelter and I couldn't take it. Bunch of losers in there. Losers out here too, but I got to deal with it until the time, you know, for God to make things right. And I'm going to be a big part of that.
Well, we're glad that we can help with some transportation, at least.
Yeah, that'd be good. Because, like, if I start working over at Patriot, they're probably going to send me places where I got to take the bus.
Oh.
So that's one of the reasons I need the tickets.
So that's kind of a day labor place?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Well, God bless you. What's your first name?
Henry.
Henry? Lord bless you, Henry, in your efforts. And I just want to encourage you to seek the Lord. Bible says, seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness. All these things shall be added unto you.
That's true.
God bless you. Here, we got some tickets for you.
All right. Thank you.
How are you doing? Good morning. God is good, isn't he?
All the time. You know it. Yes, sir.
Yes, he is.
Mm-hmm.
So what is God doing in your life right now?
Well, right now, he woke me up this morning. And I thank him for that. Thank you, Jesus.
Oh.
Then he brought me down so I can come in and give me a few tickets, you know what I'm saying? So I'm good with that. So I don't have to see nobody important today, but I got to go see my counselor down at, not BJC, but forgot the name. Deion Grand, whatever I'm talking about. Anyway, but God's been good to me, sir. Hey, like I say, he woke me up this morning. I'm giving him all the praise, you know. But anyway, hey, everything's good for me right now. I can't complain.
So are you preparing yourself for the winter to come?
Oh, yes, sir. Lord, Jesus, help me out. Got all my stuff for wintertime. See, I got a hood on that because it's kind of chilly out here. Don't get me wrong. It's still kind of chilly. It's supposed to get hot today, but anyway, yeah.
How do bus passes are going to get you to your caseworker? It's going to help you out in that way?
It's going to help me out because I'll keep it for the next week so I can, you know, if I got to move around for next week.
Does it give you a little hope?
Yes, it does. It give me a lot of little hope because, hey, if it wasn't for guys like y'all, Reverend Ray, you know, I don't know your name, sir, but anyway.
My name's Chris.
All right, Mr. Chris, anyway.
I'm the grandson of Larry Wright.
Oh, no. And your name again, Mr. Chris. Oh, Chris. Man, I ain't know that.
Yeah.
Anyway, yeah. I used to stay down at Larry Wright's back when you said over on Locust Street right there, but even though they had to leave or whatever, you know, hey, it's cool, but it's still people coming out here, so they're going to be homeless and from different states all over the world. So, hey, they might stop here. I mean, if they do, I hope everything will be a blessing for them, you know what I'm saying? They desire to get what they wanted, to get a job, housing, whatever, you know.
Well, Reverend Ray's got some bus passes for you. Thank you so much for talking with me today, and Dwight. God bless, okay? Dwight?
Uh-huh. Yes, sir.
Dwight, it's a pleasure to meet you. Truly okay, an honor.
Mr. Chris, you have a good, blessed day, too, man. Hey, hang in there, man. Hey, you know that man upstairs, don't you?
Yes, yeah. I couldn't do this job without them.
That's all you need to know.
All right. You take care, yeah, Dwight.
You have a blessing, too.
Thank you. Thank you. How are you doing today?
I'm doing just fine.
Good. What's one of the biggest struggles that you're facing right now on the streets of St. Louis?
Housing.
Housing?
Yeah.
Is it hard to find housing?
Yeah. Well, yeah, if you don't have no work, ain't nobody going to let you just run rough shoe on. Just...
Are you staying at a shelter right now?
No, I stay on the street.
How does that wear on you after a long...
Oh, man. I'm stress level up here.
Are you tired?
Yeah. Yeah, really.
Have you been attacked and had your stuff stolen?
Not yet. But, I'm not exempt, you know.
How long you been out here?
Almost 3 years.
Yeah. It's exhausting, isn't it?
Yeah. Yeah.
How do bus passes really help you out?
Oh, I can get from A to B. Take a little, you know, off my feet, you know.
All right, well, Reverend Ray has some bus passes for you, okay? Thank you for talking with me today.
Yes, sir.
All right. You guys, how are you doing today?
How you doing? I'm fine, are you?
Good. So, what are some of the struggles that you're going through right now?
Trying to pay my bills on time. Yeah, and getting a job.
So did you lose your job because of the pandemic?
Yes, yeah.
So you've got a place to stay, but it's really hard to make ends meet, isn't it?
Yeah, I got my book bag stolen with my ID and stuff in it, so it's kind of hard.
So the pandemic has really just thrown your whole life upside down, hasn't it?
Yeah, a little bit, yeah.
You're trying to find a job, though, right?
Right, yes, I am.
And these bus passes help you find that job, right?
Yes, they do. Yes, they do.
All right, well, Reverend Ray's got some for you. Thank you so much for talking with me today.
Thank you.
God bless. My name is Brian Law. I just became homeless recently. I lost my job, and my place to stay. What happened? I got attacked by a bull of my teeth. He bit the bottom of my feet. He bit my ankles. He knocked my arm, so right now I'm disabled. I mean, I can show you the wound. I lose my ID, my Social Security card, my birth certificate, and my food stamps card, so I need help. Please get the, I'm in the shelter at the Biddle House.
You're at the Biddle House, yeah. But this all just happened, right?
Yeah, within 30 days. But I had to go back for grafting, and to graft some skin off of it. So I need somebody, I need my ID though. The only way I got is medical work. I can show you that. I can show you X-ray of my bike too. Hey, brother, you remember me? Byron, yeah, I almost died, man.
I'm so sorry that all those things are happening.
My speech is kind of slurred. Because they know that this ain't my boy. Yeah, and I just thank God, and, you know, we can go out of this way anyway, any kind of way, but I never thought I'd go out with my dog. I had a little umbrella today for the rain. I said, God is not going to let me go like this. I said, Lord, so the Lord gave me the strength. I took this white foot and cut him off my left. Well, you know, we need prayer warriors and we need saints that's going to be believable.
Hey, Chris.
And I need changing socks every day. And people don't like giving me socks. You can see my face falling. And can you get a close-up on this? I got to catch this dog. Okay. He bit me in here. He tried to say I would let him. I can't take this out because it's exposed. But this is enough to show you I'm disabled. And how I make it through pain, Jesus Christ. I sing a song. I said, Lord, by your stripes we are healed, because they let me know I might lose my foot. So
I'm so sorry that all of that is happening to you right now. But
they gave me 10 shots and 17 stitches, so I went last week for the last follow-up.
And this all happened because a dog attacked you?
Yeah, I was going to the store, and he broke loose from the lady. Well, she didn't have a chain. I'm watching my stuff over here.
Yeah.
I got camcorder stuff, too. And my dear brother, she didn't have a tag on the leash, so he came and he attacked me. Yeah.
I'm so sorry that all of that is happening. So, as you can see, just one incident where a dog attacked this man, his whole life is upheaved because of the injuries that he's making. It makes it so hard for him to get around. So these bus passes really help you get.
Yeah. And this guy's telling me they're seeing pit bulls all over, and these dogs is really not. They shouldn't be on the streets. I don't know what to say, but...
What's your name?
Byron Dollar.
Byron?
Yeah.
Can I pray with you right now, Byron?
Don't want to say you need to be in a zoo, but then you got to see. Yeah, that's it.
Okay. Heavenly Father, I lift up Byron to you. I just ask that you heal him from the top of his head to the bottom of his feet, Lord. Heal his legs. Heal his body from the inside out. Heal his heart. Heal his mind, Lord. You are the great physician. You alone are powerful enough to change him from the inside out. And so I pray, standing on the promises that I read about in your word, standing on the promises that you've made me personally and the experiences that I've had, that you miraculously heal Byron, Lord, that you move in his body, Lord, that you take away the pain, that you give him courage and strength and hope to put one foot in front of the other, Lord, that you heal him mightily in the name of Jesus, Jesus Christ, your son, who came to die on the cross for Byron's sins and for my sins, Lord. We give you the glory. We give you the honor. Take these bus passes, Lord, and bless him in a mighty way. In Jesus' name, amen. So many people are hurting. So many people are in pain. You make a difference when you partner with New Life Evangelistic Center. Every single person's story is different. Everybody's situation is different. Some have jobs, some have places to go, but they're still needing assistance, and you make a difference today in so many ways. Keep praying for us. Pray for Ray. Pray for my grandfather and I as we continue to try and fill the needs through partners like you. God bless you.